back, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break a bone, me and myself talk too. I blow away the competition like a boy.
Vegas, Nevada. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
We'll watch the kickoff for New Orleans.
And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job.
Offside kick is recovered by the Buck.
Tampa Bay coming out along with a man who needs no introduction, the great Tom Brady.
What I enjoyed this week is that you asked to talk to his offensive center before the game and find out a little bit more about him and what the relationship is. And that was a pretty positive story, wasn't it?
Yeah, and really what I took away from that is just how it has permeated throughout the entire offensive line, the relationship they've had. It's really a group that's in sync.
They care about him. That's the thing. They really care. And when you care that much, you're going to play that much harder for him. Chance to lead the team to wins.
Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And now it's second down.
It's now second and 10.
Throwing again. Brady. This throw is going to be incomplete. Evans once again the intended receiver, and it's third down.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And that's incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. And 10. Here's Breeze. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
The ground. This is Leonard Fournette. A nice opening right away as he'll maneuver his way up to the 32-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and a yard.
From the gun, it's Brady. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down. Missed on his first three passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection, maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you wonder, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
Pickup of 6. Brings up second and 4 at the 14-yard line.
Brady gives this one off to Jones. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
A gain of a yard. Brings up 3rd and 3.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a 1st and goal. So 1st and goal from the 9-yard line. Now he'll throw with Brady. And it's caught.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A gain of 7 that time. Second goal.
Brings up second and goal at the 2-yard line.
Now Brady. And this is going to be intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
This interception will go on the record of the quarterback, but as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot. Square your body to the quarterback and be ready to make the catch.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
Second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
To throw, it's Breeze. All going for Sanders downfield. And got his man complete. And all the way down to the 35. It's a big play there for the Saints. 45 yards.
Not sure much more could have been done there defensively. Went up with him. Tried to knock it away. Tried to get an arm in. Unsuccessfully.
The throw over the middle. Taken in. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Michael Thomas. 35 yards. And the Saints have taken the early lead. And that touchdown drive happened very, very quickly. You knew that they had the quick strike ability. They showed it.
And for a defense that understands that, it still drives them crazy when it actually happens to them. Fast and furious, there came the points.
Will Lutz on for the point after. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. That's caught. The tight end held. And he is not going to make it. They stop him up short. And this will remain a 6-0 ball game. I thought the days of the fake extra point were numbered once they moved these kicks back to the 15. Apparently, I was mistaken.
Yeah, I was wondering who was ever going to try to do this. In fact, I couldn't wonder anything it would ever happen, taking a fake from the 15-yard line to try and pick up an extra point. I didn't think anyone would ever call this.
Well, a good-looking return setup here. Pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me. At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves. A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Third and two.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Jones. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, 3 plays, all 3 short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Brady now on first down. Over the middle here to Brown. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line.
Antonio Brown.
A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6. 6-0 our score after 1. Looking to throw again on second down. Brady, that's out to his running back for now. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 36. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
They go back to the ground with Jones. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
At the 38-yard line.
Second and 12. Shotgun now for Brady. Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
The Bucs on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. From the gun, Brady. He gets it in the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down by about a yard as they find a way to convert there on 3rd down and 5. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. And that's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
Jones, the ball carrier.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
1 yard line. It's a gain of 5. Brings up 2nd and 5.
Operating from the gun, Brady. He completes this into the hands of Miller. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down.
It's a gain of 2. Brings up 3rd and 3.
Here's Jones, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Well, if they continue to run the football this strong right up the middle, I don't know if they can wait till halftime to make adjustments. They better find a way to get it done series to series. I don't know if they need to sub some guys out, bring in extra people, maybe change what they're doing on the defensive side of the ball. But right now, they're running the ball very well right at them and right up the middle.
So another 3rd down conversion, and now they've got a 1st and goal. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And the Buccaneers are going to be set up with a 1st and goal as good running gets him down to about the 4-yard line. 5 yards, a good run there, and now 2nd and goal.
Brings up 2nd and goal.
On 2nd down. It's Jones, and he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Bucs are just an extra point away from grabbing the lead now.
But they decided to run it in and got it done on 3rd and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
The kicker, this has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
He's got it, and they take the lead at 7-6. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told. And it's Ronald Jones that polishes it off with a touchdown run. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. On the return, Deontay Harris. Turns, he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
The Saints take over 1st and 10 at their own 29.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Throwing on 1st down is Breeze. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas.